Hello dear students, so in the today's class let us discuss about the liquid crystals. So liquid crystals are the intermediate between the liquid state and the solid state. So the organic solids having rod-like molecules which do not melt to give the liquid substance directly. Instead, these organic solids will pass through an intermediate state, so which is called as the liquid crystal state, or simply you can call it as the liquid crystal. So the liquid crystals are the organic solids which are intermediate between the liquid state and the solid state. So here you can see the crystalline solid upon heating, so which first converts into the liquid crystal, so then it forms the normal liquid. So the liquid crystals are intermediate between the liquid state and the solid state. So the examples for the liquid crystal, so the para azoxy anisole, ethyl para azoxyl benzoate, para cholesterol benzoate. So next let us move on to the types of liquid crystals. So based on the molecular arrangement of the liquid crystals, so the liquid crystals can be classified into three types. So under that, the first one is the smectic, so that means soup like liquid crystals. So these smectic crystals, liquid crystals, have the layered structure with well defined interlayer spacing in one direction only, so which are called as the smectic liquid crystals. So example, the ethyl para azoxy benzoate, ethyl para azoxy cinnamate, and the n-octyl para azoxy cinnamate. So next let us see the properties of these smectic crystals. So the smectic crystals, these smectic crystals, say they do not flow like the normal liquids, so that means their viscosity is different from the normal liquids. So the different planes or the sheets glide over one another. So in case of the smectic crystals, as you know, so the smectic crystals have the layered structure with well defined interlayer spacing. Okay, so therefore when these liquid crystals flow, so the planes or the sheets will glide over one another. So that's how the smectic crystals will flow. So when the smectic crystals are spread over a glass surface, so they form a series of terraces or the strata, layers. So they have the complex structure, they appear fan-like structure in polarized light. So these smectic crystals, see, they do not affected by a magnetic field. So these are the properties of the first type of liquid crystals, so that is smectic liquid crystals. So next let us move on to the second type of liquid crystals. So the second type of liquid crystals are the nematic or thread like liquid crystals. So in case of the nematic liquid crystals, so the molecules are parallel to each other like soda straws, so that means thread like. So but these are free to slide or roll individually. So such type of the liquid crystals are called as the nematic liquid crystals. So the example, the para methoxy cinnamic acid, dibenzal benzidine, or para azoxy phenetol. So next, let us see the properties of these nematic liquid crystals. These nematic liquid crystals flow more readily than the smectic liquid crystals. So these nematic liquid crystals have the low coefficient of viscosity. So because of the low coefficient of viscosity, so these nematic crystals will flow more easily when compared to the smectic liquid crystals. So these nematic crystals do not conduct electricity in their pure form. So the next property, so these nematic crystals appear thread-like in polarized light. So these nematic crystals are affected by the magnetic field. So these are the properties of the second type of liquid crystals. So that is the nematic or thread-like liquid crystals. So next, let us move on to the third type of liquid crystals. So that is the cholesteric liquid crystals. So in case of the cholesteric liquid crystals, some smectic and some nematic characters are present. So such crystals are called as the cholesteric liquid crystal. So that means these cholesteric crystals will possess the properties of both the smectic crystals as well as the nematic crystals, liquid crystals. So here you can see the smectic liquid crystal. So when it is heated, so it passes through an intermediate state, that means it forms the cholesteric liquid crystal, then it finally it will going to form the nematic liquid crystals. Okay, so therefore this cholesteric liquid crystal will possess the characteristics of both the smectic liquid crystal as well as the nematic liquid crystals. So the examples, that is the cholesterol, myristate, ethyl anisole, para-aminosinamate. So then coming to the properties of these cholesteric liquid crystals. So these cholesteric liquid crystals have very high optical rotation. So that means they rotate the plane polarized light to a very high rotation. So they diffract the light. So these cholesteric crystals appeared colored in polarized light. So these cholesteric liquid crystals possess the helical structure. So these cholesteric crystals have more than one transition temperature. So because of the properties of the smectic liquid crystal as well as the nematic liquid crystals, so these cholesteric liquid crystals will possess more than one transition temperature. So next, let us discuss about the applications of these liquid crystals. So the applications of liquid crystals. So because of the mechanical and electrical properties of the liquid crystals, which lies between the crystalline solid and the isotropic liquids, so these liquid crystals are used in the gas liquid chromatography. Gas liquid chromatography. So these liquid crystals are used in the digital display, like the pocket calculators, digital wristwatches. So because these liquid crystals will consume very little electrical power, so because of their less electrical consumption, so the liquid crystals are used as the digital displays in calculators and digital wrist watches. So these liquid crystals are used in the study of the structure of anisotropic molecules spectroscopically. So these liquid crystals are used as a solvent in case of the study of the structure of the anisotropic molecules spectroscopically. So it is used, liquid crystals are used as the solvents. So the next U, application of the liquid crystals. So the cholesteric crystals, liquid crystals are used to detect the tumors in the body by a method called as the thermography. So these are the applications of the liquid crystals.